Over the last 2 years, I've been working with him in property, and after hearing him speak with clients and, you know, his level of knowledge and experience that he had, he's got the substance to back up what he says.
He explained exactly what subdivision and what subdividing meant, the pitfalls. He gave me a good list of what the costs involved in doing a simple subdivision were. Look, Chris, you've been fantastic.
Well, hello again, everybody. I'm Chris Freeman, and I'll be presenting the 21st Century Subdivision Home Study. I'm just going to share with you now what we'll be doing tomorrow. We'll be going out and filming a day in the life of Chris Freeman. So you'll get to experience firsthand what a real-life property developer does. So tomorrow we'll be going and looking at the city of Geelong, where we're looking at various projects that I'm currently doing there. We'll also be looking at various infrastructure, like the Avalon Airport that is owned by Lindsay Fox in particular. He's just been given $15 million by the state government to build an international airport. It's only kilometres from the subdivision site. We'll also be meeting up with some of the team, the development team out there. We normally have brunch or lunch at the at an oceanfront restaurant on the pier. We'll then be going up in the helicopter to have a look at all the infrastructure and development sites from the air, and we'll be filming that as well. And after we've completed that, we'll then be going to, you know, some actual projects that are actually ready to lodge with council. So it's going to be a very exciting day, so you'll be able to get the full visuals of what it's like. And after that, we'll be basically looking and filming some of the infrastructure, like train stations and things like that. So it's going to be a really exciting day, and I'm looking forward to capturing all this on film for the home study.
Beautiful spring day, 25 degrees, not a cloud in the sky. I'm standing out the front of Avalon Airport, only kilometres from Geelong and the projects. For those people that don't know, one of Australia's most successful businessmen, Lindsay Fox, owns this. He's just received a $15 million grant to build an international airport here, which means that if you live and retire in Geelong, that, you know, you can come here and catch a plane to anywhere in the world, thanks to Lindsay.
Yeah, so we're just driving through Cryo at the moment, on the right-hand side. It's that's the target area there. It's walking distance to the train station, a major shopping centre, McDonald's on the left-hand side you'll see coming up. Dan Murphy's, so you've got it all here. Cryo is the closest suburb to Melbourne. It is 65 km from Melbourne. Geelong is sort of spread out, sprawling city of about 20 kilometres, so nice and handy to Melbourne. All the way from Melbourne to here, we've been on a 6-lane carriageway. That's quite significant because that provides, you know, free-flowing traffic. It's a very easy drive. Soon we'll be entering the suburb of Norlane, which is another target area. We will be sourcing some properties there as well. It adjoins Cryo. Now, all the houses usually are, you know, all of concrete brick construction. Again, they have to be positioned on the right, you know, right part of the block of land. Most of the blocks are around the 700 square metres. They're code compliant.
Welcome to Geelong. We're overlooking Port Phillip Bay, the Geelong Marina, the pier. On the headland over there, you can see the Botanical Gardens. We can see the Geelong CBD. We can see Deakin University, one of the only oceanfront universities in Australia. And we can see all the boats. So lots of people live out here. They've got a boat parked there or in the marina. So we'll head down now to the pier for some for breakfast and a meeting with the team.
So just on the right hand side here is Deakin University, which is on the Geelong waterfront here, which is what a great place to study. I haven't seen too many universities like that. We'll be going past the new hospitals and all sorts of things later today, the Geelong City Council, the titles office. So here we are at the pier.
My favourite restaurants, it's a brasserie restaurant. We're enjoying brunch here, and this is pretty normal for myself and the development team. Again, a day in the life of Chris Freeman. So later today, we're going to be exploring Geelong. We'll be showing you some of the iconic schools here, Geelong Grammar, Geelong College. Whereas I was just told recently that even 30 years ago, it cost you $40,000 a year to go to Geelong College. These schools are, you know, they're iconic. People from all over the world, China, all places of the world, come send their children here, and sometimes these children stay on and form relationships and get jobs in the local economy, so it's very significant.
We've purchased properties around the $225,000 level in Corio and Norlay.
Yep.
And what we try and do is secure them on a 20% deposit, means that there's no lender's mortgage insurance. It's a lot easier for the land, but it always varies with the particular client. But what we've done is we've done our 20% down, and it might have been $50,000, $60,000. Then we've gone and done our planning application and our infrastructure work, and that's around, varies because every location is different, Chris, but we always do an analysis before we buy a property, and we do a profile on it, and that's what your clients will actually see, all your students, and we'll deliver more information on how we do that throughout the course. The great thing about it, well, I'll say again, is that the ordinary person can get into the strategy, and I think like your previous guest mentioned, they can learn how to do something, and then they can apply this in a different area around Melbourne, and they get an even better uplift.
Doing a subdivision, a battle axe subdivision for Chris isn't much at all. He's come from doing literally thousands of subdivisions in Queensland. So when you've gone that far, doing one or two subdivisions, you know, battle axe subdivisions, it's a piece of cake. So you really want someone who's already gone to the end, already done all that, because then step one is just so easy.
Spit your venom, keep it shut. I hate it when you hiss and preach about your new messiah, cause your theories catch fire. I can't find no silver lining. I don't mean to judge, but when you read your speech, it's tiring. Enough is enough. I'm covering my ears like a king.
I did it not for the financial result, I did it to learn the strategy so I could do it myself. Because that's essentially what everyone should do. You should invest to learn, you should work to learn, never go for the money up front. The more you learn, the more you educate yourself early on, the more it will help you in the end.
We're now leaving the restaurant, we've had our brunch there, we're now heading off to the helipad.
Greatest beliefs is that you should always place yourself in inspiring environments whenever possible, and that would include oceanfront restaurants, helicopters, super yachts, everything good quality, good quality food. My role, as you know, is to inspire people first and foremost, and that's what I do. And just sharing that with you guys, so whenever possible, you know, treat yourselves and get out there amongst it, and you know, don't stay at home, get out there and get to some inspirational places.
massive marina here. It's literally got hundreds and hundreds of beautiful yachts parked there. We can see people enjoying their catamarans and, you know, going out in their little rafts out to their boats. People lying, sunbathing here on the beach. Just a spectacular place and a spectacular day.